Thank you. must admit, Cassandra, I've never heard of these seekers of truth.
Why would you? They do not exist in Tevinter.
But what are they? Some manner of super Templar? Is this one of those sudden secrets like proper hygiene?
Once we worked from the shadows, monitoring Templars and mages alike.
Ah, that clearly worked out well.
Your glibness does you no credit. The mage rebellion was beyond even our power to control.
This place be more damp.
Thank you. minute if you need something.
I told them the offer was the best to do.
Our soldiers handled themselves well in Adamant.
We've come a long way since Haven. I fear there's still a ways to go, but we're prepared.
Let us begin.
I'll leave you to your work.
Never trust half an elf.
I found the amulet that Solas told us about. Would you like to try it on?
Yes. but not here. I like it here. We need some place that can go away if it becomes sharp. What do I do with it?
You found one of the amulets. Excellent. May I? It is simple enough. You put it on, I charge it with magic, and you should be protected.
Are you ready, Cole?
They can't make me a monster. Blood mages from binding me like the demons at Adamant. But it didn't work.
Something is interfering with the enchantment.
Something like Cole not being a demon?
Solas, is it possible that the amulet doesn't work on Cole because he's too human?
Regardless of Cole's special circumstances, he remains a spirit.
Yes. A spirit who is strangely like a person.
I don't matter. Just lock away the parts of me that someone else could knot together to make me follow.
Focus on the amulet. Tell me what you feel.
Warm, soft blanket covering. But it catches tears. I'm the wrong shape. There's something... There. That way.
We'll find whatever is preventing the amulet from working, and we'll make it right.
All right, kid. Get Cullen and work with him on the map to figure out where you're sensing something wrong.
Will you come with me? All of you?
Sure. All right, I get it. You like spirits. But he came into this world to be a person. Let him be one.
If I see a way to protect Cole without taking away whatever he is, I'll use it. But Cole clearly needs our help.
I'm not saying we do nothing. But that ritual of theirs only works on demons, right?
This is not some fanciful story. Child of the stone? We cannot change our nature by wishing.
You don't think?
However we deal with the problem, our next step is to track down whatever is interfering with the enchantment.
Yeah, this should get me through the month. Now give me a moment. Greetings. Can I help you?
You. You killed me.
What? I don't even know you.
You forgot. You locked me in the dungeon in the Spire, and you forgot, and I died in the dark!
The Spire?
Cole, stop!
Just take it easy, kid.
He killed me! He killed me! That's why it doesn't work. He killed me, and I have to kill him back.
Before anyone gets killed, I need to know what's going on.
Cole, this man cannot have killed you. You are a spirit. You have not even possessed a body.
A broken body, bloody, banged on the stone cell, guts gripping in the dark, dank. A captured apostate. They threw him into the dungeon in the spire at Valroyo. They forgot about him. He starved to death. I came through to help. And I couldn't. So I became him. Cole.
If Cole was an apostate, that'd make the guy we just saw a Templar. Must have been buying lyrium.
Let me kill him. I need to.
Solus?
We cannot let Cole kill the man.
I don't think anyone was going to suggest that, Chuckles.
Cole is a spirit. The death of the real Cole wounded him, perverted him from his purpose. To regain that part of himself, he must forgive.
Come on. You don't just forgive someone killing you.
You don't. A spirit can.
Varric.
Kid's angry. He needs to work through it.
A spirit does not work through emotions. It embodies them.
But he isn't a spirit, is he? He made himself human. And humans change. They get hurt. And they heal. He needs to work it out like a person.
You would alter the essence of what he is.
He did that to himself when he left the Fade. I'm just helping him survive it.
Before I decide anything, I need a clearer picture of what happened.
It seems the real Cole was an apostate, captured and taken to the Circle by Templars.
Who aren't known for their gentle nature.
As the young man starved to death in a dungeon, his pain caught the attention of a spirit, likely one of compassion.
Compassion?
An uncommon spirit, certainly, and all too fragile when its efforts to help prove to be in vain.
Cole will never grow into a real person until he comes to terms with what happened.
Leave it to me. All right, kid. You want revenge? Come with me.
I'm so sorry.
Sorry isn't going to help him now, is it, kid?
No.
Pull the trigger and put him down like a mad dog. Do it.
No!
How you doing, kid? Feel any better?
No.
You can't make it all just go away. I learned that the hard way.
Forget.
No. He needs to remember. You too. We're done here.
For all we know, the amulet will now never function. Cole remains vulnerable to binding.
No, he isn't. The amulet didn't work because he's too human, right? Maybe now the kid's also too human for that binding magic to work on him.
I hope you're right.
It still hurts. When do I stop hurting?
Being with your friends can make you feel better.
Come on, kid. Let's go for a walk. It'll clear your head.
The left hand misses a friend with two different names. She's hurting, sad, alone, but everyone can see me now. They remember. How do I put honey in Leliana's wine without her noticing?
I can help with that.
It is good that he is not entirely changed, however human he becomes.
I've been looking all over for you. You're just in time. We almost had to start without you.
We couldn't have that, could we?
I found her, Ruffles. Deal her in.
I do hope I recall the rules. It's been ages since I've played a game of Wicked Grace.
Grab a seat. We're ready to start.
Are we playing cards or what?
Are three drakes better than a pair of swords? Ugh, I can never remember.
Seeker, remember how I said, don't show anyone your hand? That rule includes announcing it to the table.
There's a crown on his head, but a sword too. His head didn't want either.
Don't talk to the face cards, kid.
You seem to have enough people. I have 1,000 things to do.
Losing money can be both relaxing and habit-forming. Give it a try.
Curly, if any man in history ever needed a hobby, it's you.
Dealer starts. Oh, I believe I'll start at... Oh, 3 coppers. Do you think that's too daring? Maybe I'll make it 1. No. Boldness. 3 it is.
Seriously, who starts? Silver or go home.
Sounds good. I'm in.
Bolder the better, right? I'm in.
Me too. Well, are you in?
I'm in, and raising another silver.
You haven't even looked at your cards.
Our illustrious leader is betting we're bluffing.
You are bluffing.
Poor recruit ran out into the dining hall in nothing but his knickers.
And this profound silence fell over the hall as 70 mages and 30 Templars all turned to stare at once. Then a slow round of applause began and spread until every soul was on their feet. A standing ovation.
What did he do?
Saluted, turned on his heel, and marched out like he was in full armor.
He did not.
Good man.
You're shitting us.
That's how you know it's true. I could never put that in a book. Too unlikely.
I think we need another round of drinks.
I'll get them. Don't start without me.
And the dealer takes everything. I win again.
Deal again. I figured out your tells, Lady Ambassador.
Commander, everyone knows a lady has no tells.
Then let's see if your good fortune lasts one more hand.
I want another chance to win my dignity back. Deal me in.
Don't say a word, dwarf.
I tried to warn you, Curly.
Never bet against an Antivan, Commander.
I'm leaving. I don't want to witness our commander's walk of shame back to the barracks.
Well, I do.
It comes off. I didn't know it came off.
I'm glad you decided to join us tonight. It's too easy to mistake you for the Inquisitor.
I enjoyed this.
See? That's what I mean. It's easy to forget you're not just an icon or symbol. Like those statues of Andraste holding bowls of fire. At least it is for me. You up for another game when this is all over, Inquisitor?
I wouldn't miss it.
Good. It'll take me a while to talk Cullen into it. Maybe I'll work the revenge angle.
Who's that? Did I win?
Need something? Or are you just here to admire the dwarf?
Tell me the truth, Varric. Do you actually think I was sent by Andraste?
Shit. This is going to be awkward. I guess I do. Either you're guided by the hand of some higher power, or you have the worst luck.
I wouldn't have pegged you as an Andrastian.
It's a great story. It's got heroism, love, betrayal, and random musical numbers. What's not to like? I don't have a nug in this race. It could be bullshit, it could be true. I'll never know. But I like the idea that maybe you could save the world with a song.
Let's be realistic. It could be both.
You've got a point. Look at all the shit that's happened to you. You were saved from the explosion that leveled a mountaintop and fell out of the Fade. You traveled through time, face down one of the ancient magisters who started the Blights, had a mountain fall on you, and lived, stopped an army of demons. One of those things would be impossible. All of them together? That's a miracle.
So, on the basis of my extraordinarily bad luck, you think I'm Andraste's herald?
If you know the story of Andraste, you know that bad luck is sort of her thing. If you've got questions, I'm your dwarf.
I read your Tale of the Champion, and I have...
That's a pretty common reaction. Go ahead.
Carry on.
Greetings.
I need to know more about Corypheus.
Taken his army. He lacks the conventional forces to take Orlais. He must see Orlais destroyed utterly by whatever means possible. Not merely thrown into chaos.
I'd like to hear more about what you saw in your exploration of the Fade.
I would be happy to share it with you.
Tell me about the old ruins you explored.
I found an ancient dwarven taig no longer sheltered by the stone. An earthquake had exposed it all to daylight. 1,000 dwarven corpses lay, the victims of a darkspawn horde. Their last stand marked by one great ring of armor. In the middle, one small body, clutching tightly to a small stuffed toy.
Tell me about a spirit you encountered.
The Alamari crossed the Frostback Mountains to escape a beast they called the Shadow Goddess in their story. I met the spirit, but they fled. She walks the Fade along the southern tundra, weeping lonely and forgotten. Great Ferelden formed because a lonely spirit drove her prey away.
Tell me about the old memories you found in the Fade.
I saw a dwarf emerge into the light of day and shield his eyes against the sun. The first time he had seen it, the tears were streaming from his eyes. I sought them from the blazing light, until I saw the rock he held so tightly. Then he laid the rock down gently, and he left it as he walked away.
We'll talk later.
Goodbye.
Remarkably little here on early Tevinter history. All these gifts to the Inquisition, and the best they can do is the Malefica Imperio. Trite propaganda. But if you want 20 volumes on whether Divine Galatea took a shit on Sunday, this is evidently the place to find it.
That's the Dorian I know, critiquing every book in my library.
I wouldn't have to if you could find some rebellious heretic archivist to join the cause.
Are there rebellious archivists? Other than you, that is.
If Corypheus ever starts burning masterworks of literature, I'm sure a few will pop up. Did I see something by Genitivi here? I could have sworn.
What is this about, Dorian?
What else could it be about? What happened at Adamant, of course. We went into the Fade. Physically went in. Are you... all right?
Stroud is gone.
The Fade is an ordeal under normal circumstances. To be the only real thing there, beyond description. That any of us made it out alive is difficult to believe. You do realize this feat hasn't been performed in over 1,000 years. Corypheus and his contemporaries entered the Fade and began the Blights. In comparison,
at least you were at my side.
No offense, but I'd almost rather I hadn't been.
No sense of adventure? That's surprising.
I've not your talent for survival. And not everyone is as discerning as I. If you can walk in the Fade, others will try to follow. Who knows what secrets Corypheus has revealed? Not all of them will be as lucky as you. What they could unleash. My advice? Keep this quiet. Let them speculate. Too many will see this as a challenge.
That's a good idea.
There are enough idiots in the world who think if they just use enough blood magic, their problems will vanish. It's exactly the sort of thing I want to stop back home. This I don't need. What I do need is a copy of the Liberalum. I'll wager I can find Corypheus's real name. If I can prove he was a grasping ankle biter with no family to speak of, the luster would come right off. Wish me luck.
You seem very interested in my opinions.
I should go.
You know where I'll be.
I'm proud you gave the Grey Wardens another chance, Inquisitor. Would I have done the same, I wonder? Forgiveness can be difficult. I hope the Order values what you've done and gives you no reason to regret it.
You were once a Grey Warden.
Mine is an unusual circumstance, Inquisitor. Normally one is part of the Order until death. But long ago I found myself stripped of what made me a Warden. They tried to reinitiate me, but nothing worked. Nor could they figure out how it happened. So I was sent to the Circle of Magi, the first warden ever to be kicked out. Quite the achievement.
You sound happy about it.
Becoming a warden seemed like a dream when I was first conscripted. Towards the end, however, my brothers and sisters, they felt I had somehow cheated death. I was glad to leave. It also made me unique in the Circle. I had an opportunity to do more than I ever could as a warden.
You mean you began the Mage Rebellion?
I pushed for our vote to free the Circles of Magi. But I cannot claim sole responsibility for what followed. Still, despite all the chaos, I would do it again. What happened had to happen.
You're not still the Grand Enchanter, then?
Any claim I had to the title ended along with the Circles of Magi, although some still call me by it. Perhaps the Circles will one day be resurrected. If so, another will take the position. Until that time, I lead my fellow mages by default. I will do what I can for them.
You believe they'll recreate the Circle of Magi after all this?
It depends on who the next divine is, and what she offers. We can't go back to the way things were. But endless warfare benefits no one. That is why I agreed to Justinia's conclave. There must be another solution.
I've been meaning to ask, how exactly did the Venatori take control in Redcliff?
Mages constantly found their way to us while we were there. Stragglers, most of them strangers. I had no way of knowing some were actually Tevinter. They spread whispers, encouraged talk of an alliance, and we were desperate. I'm not proud of our choice, but we were certain Templars were coming. It could have ended far worse.
I trust everything is well with the mages.
There have been a few scuffles with your Templars, but overall, it is going well.
I'll leave you to it. A request has been made of you, Inquisitor. Here it is. As you were.
Yes, Inquisitor.
I'll leave you to your work.
Yes?
Inquisitor.
There is a problem that needs your attention, Inquisitor.
Magic exists to serve man and never to rule over him.
Inquisitor, the soldiers say you banished the demons at Adamant and freed the Grey Warden mages. I understand from Sister Leliana that the truth is somewhat more complex, but no less extraordinary. She said that you spoke with a figure in the Fade that seemed to be the soul of Divine Justinia. I suspect many of the faithful would like to know what Justinia told you.
I'm sorry. That was between me and her.
Of course, Inquisitor. Not every vision is meant for the ears of all the world. Some burdens you must carry alone. Now, is there anything I can help you with?
Can you tell me how our people are doing?
What would you like to know?
How are our forces at Skyhold doing?
We have many injured. The siege of Adamant was brutal for all involved. Even so, more flock to your banner. They have heard that the Inquisition defeated the legendary Grey Wardens. Your soldiers have been blooded, Inquisitor. They are veterans now. An army in more than just name.
Do you have information on people elsewhere?
The refugees in the hinterlands are desperate. Without help, starvation or war will claim many lives. Villagers in Crestwood are besieged by their own dead. They have sent word begging for assistance. People are vanishing in the hills of Emprise de Lyon. It may be demons or something worse, but they are terrified. More than that, I cannot say. It is a chaotic time for all in Olay and Ferelden.
Farewell, revered mother.
Be well, Inquisitor.
Your worship. Thank you for Haven. Less so for Redcliffe, but I am committed to serve your worship.
For you are the fire at the heart of the world.
Maker, though the darkness comes upon me, I shall embrace the light.
Hello again.
That's enough for now.
Another time, then.
I have another message for Bonnie.
I think that's...
Whatever you need.
How's it going? Do we have what we need?
With Skyhold shining like a beacon? You name it, it's here or on the way. I've wrung out the slackers, given them what for. I think I like this job.
As you were.
We are here for you, Inquisitor.
Inquisitor.
Hey.
What's been going on?
Not much. The usual. Nice of you to ask.
What's been going on?
They've done a lot with this place. I'm impressed.
What's been going on?
Just relaxing. Taking a breath. You need to sometimes to keep sane.
Take care.
wonder what it is that gives Grey Wardens their legendary skill and stamina. I should like to study one. Would that fine fellow I've seen in your company consent to a careful examination? Somewhat off-color today, Inquisitor? An excess of bile, perhaps. Might I bleed you, or offer a herbal tonic? Try not to touch the leeches. They are quite delicate. A word to the wise. When all else fails, amputate. Ah, excuse the smells in the infirmary. Someone spilled their guts not an hour ago. Literally. Your visits do lift the spirits of the wounded, Inquisitor. Inquisitor.
Inquisitor, you have come to the attention of the powerful, and I am the response. Monsieur Faris at your service. You will find my wares unique. I sell influence. Yes, Inquisitor. How will you choose to extend your reach today?
Greetings, Your Worship.
Lady Inquisitor, Bonnie Sims at your service. I trust good secret was not too coarse. Now that you've come to some good fortune, you deserve an upgrade. As master of the tradesmen, I stand ready to supply your every need.
How are you doing? Good business?
In this gilded fortress? How could we not be?
Skyhold needs a healthy flow of goods. How can I help?
One of the major hubs is freed. Continue on this path, and you're on your way.
Who or what are the tradesmen?
A following of sympathetic and profit-minded individuals who promote local craftsmen and fair importers. A guild of sorts. Although that implies counter affiliations, we are not interested in crossing. Our purpose in the Inquisition is legitimate and honorable. You will have what you need at honest prices.
Segret survived Haven. Where is he?
About. Doing good work for you and yours. But this position is now more desirable. It was time arrangements were made. I shall make every effort to prove that this is an upgrade.
Why are you a mere merchant if you're the master of this group?
I wish to avoid the suggestion that I am a posturing commander atop a structure of malcontents. It is better to remain active, hands-on. Do you not agree, Inquisitor?
What do you bring to the Inquisition?
What you need, and more. It takes great coordination to make a remote location seem central. While there is no doubt the boutiques of Valroyo display the grandest of the grand, they do not travel. At least, not yet.
We'll speak another time.
Of course, Lady Inquisitor.
Well,
how are your charges? Well supplied?
Oversupplied. Never thought a mountain pass could seem like luxury.
Farewell.
Maker be with you.
Inquisitor.
What do you think of the Inquisition?
I just know that you could shake this world to its foundations if you willed it.
We should return to our duties.
As you wish. You are, after all, in charge.
Good to see you.
Is there anything I should know?
Only that I'm never playing cards again. I still can't find my... No, it doesn't matter. I don't know how Varric talked me into that.
That's too bad. Watching you lose made me want to play cards more often.
I do not need help embarrassing myself in front of you.
You were blushing. It was adorable.
Maker's breath.
Is there anything I should know?
Creating Inquisition footholds outside Skyhold has strengthened our reputation. People view us as a stabilizing force. We've received a number of recruits eager to pledge themselves to our cause.
Is there anything I should know?
Many of our recruits viewed the Grey Wardens as heroes. Blackwall's presence is helpful. Knowing there's one warden immune to corruption has given people hope. Corypheus's grasp is not inescapable.
Is there anything I should know?
There are fewer arguments between our Templar and Mage recruits than when we started. I've seen them trading stories, building one another up for the fight to come. I pray this won't be lost when their common enemy is gone.
Is there anything I should know?
Not at present.
Do you have some time?
Of course.
I thought you could use a break.
I would like that.
They should have been born together, but instead they were bound by light.
How would you like to get out of here? Maybe do something fun?
I don't know. I've never tried.
Come on.
Inquisitor, you honor us with your presence. May I bring a sampling of fine cheeses for you and your guest?
I don't eat.
Well then, just a bottle of a fine Ghislaine White to start. Please enjoy your meal this evening, your worship.
He saw me. They all see me.
Next you'll be eating and drinking and everything else.
What else is there?
Have you used the privy yet? That should be enlightening.
I find people when their pain leaves them open. I ease the pain. I leave, they forget. That was enough for me. Now they remember, and I'm not sure...
Cole?
I told you about Rhys, the mage who could see me, my friend. My only friend for a long time. Evangeline showed me that Templars could be kind, but even she...
Cole, if this is troubling, we don't have to talk about it.
Gentle. You watch me walk into darkness over and over, and you always worry. Thank you. But this isn't about them. It's about... When I found out I wasn't human, when I grew, I lost Rhys. I lost my only friend. That's why I was scared about letting all these people see me. That's why I laughed.
You're covering the fear with laughter.
No. This world taught me that changing means losing your friends. But now I know that doesn't have to be true. I have enough self to know that what I felt was foolish. Isn't it wonderful?
It's another good step, Cole.
I might like being human. What do you think I'll learn next?